Hello everyone. So we are now into the second section of refraction of light through plane surface, and this section is termed as refraction through prism. This is very interesting. I'll be explaining everything of this section to you in this video, and be sure after watching this video you should sit with your textbook, which is Concise Physics, and go through the section, practice the diagrams, so that it will be easier for you. Just after watching the video, please complete the section. All right? And remember one thing, while watching this video, you should have your classwork in front, because you have to, you know, copy, or you have to do sums and all. So keep your classwork copy ready. Okay? Here we go.
Okay, so after the recap session, this is the new section in your book. It is the second section, which is refraction of light through prism. Now, in order to know this, first of all, you have to understand the basic structure of a prism, which I have drawn here. You can see we have a rectangular base and we have two triangular fronts and back. So it is basically a solid, and it is always kept on its base on the table or wherever you are performing the experiment to visualize what happens when light enters into a prism. Now, first of all, we should understand that according to Snell's law of, that is, laws of refraction, here, since in the Snell's law it was stated that for a particular color of light and for a particular pair of media. So these two lines are very important. That means for a particular pair of media and for a particular color of light. So here we are assuming that any light ray which is incident on this refracting surfaces of prism is basically a monochromatic light. Please don't get confused. This is not white light, because what happens when white light is on the surface of a prism, we'll come to know later on. Right now, we are thinking that light which is entering into the prism is a monochromatic, is a single color light. Please don't confuse. Okay? Now, so this is what we have. There are certain things that I should tell you. The first thing is the apex angle. Can you see here? Apex angle. This apex angle is known as angle of prism. Angle of prism. And these two inclined surfaces, these two inclined surfaces are called the refracting surface of prism. And this is, of course, the base. Now, prism usually does one peculiar thing, that is, whatever light is incident on prism, it eventually bends the light or deviates the light towards its base only. This is a natural phenomenon. Whatever be the reason, it will always deviate the light towards its base. This is the general sequence that occurs in a prism, and we are using a monochromatic light. And again, I repeat, this is not a white light. Okay, so now please concentrate, this diagram. We have taken a vertical cross section of this prism and we have got a triangular section. And OP is the incident ray of light, which is incident at point P. Then it should have traveled in this path if the prism was absent. And finally, when the prism is there, the light is undergoing first refraction here. It is angle of incidence I. The first refraction occurs here, which is the angle of refraction is R1. Now it is going into the second refracting surface. Now here the interesting facts occurs. That is, the first case, light is traveling from rarer to denser, so it is going towards the normal. Second case, light is traveling from denser to rarer, so it is going away from the normal. This is the normal and it is going away. So finally we had a path like this, and finally we have a path like this. If they intersect, then we are getting a point D here. And this sign, this is delta. This is delta, which means the angle of deviation. That means it is the angle by which the light has deviated due to the presence of the prism. Alright? Because of what? Because of two refractions which are occurring at the two refracting surfaces of the prism. Okay? Sure? Good. Now, let us find out some expression for this delta. That means the angle of deviation. We have to calculate what is the value in exact for this angle of deviation. And for that, we will go for like this. It's very simple. Very simple. Because we can see here a triangle. DPQ. Again, I repeat, we can see a triangle here. D, P and Q. Okay? And we know the exterior angle is the sum of the total interior angles, the sum of these two. So delta can be written as the sum of the angle DPQ plus DQP. DQP. Alright? Sure? Now what is angle DPQ? You can see this angle I is vertically opposite to this two whole angle. Alright? And this much is R1. So in order to calculate DPQ, what should we do? We can just subtract I minus R1. Simple. Next is DQP. The same thing. Again, E is the emergent angle. And this is vertically opposite to this hole. And here is R2. So it is E minus R2. Alright. So DPQ is I minus R1. DQP is E minus R2. Right. So we can just have a calculation like I plus E minus R1 plus R2. So this is the expression we have got, delta equals to I plus E, that angle of incidence plus angle of emergence minus the sum of two angle of refractions which are occurring inside the prism. Alright?
Now we have to calculate the expression, this one, that is R1 plus R2. We have got this expression, I repeat, delta equals to angle of incidence plus angle of emergence minus the sum of two angle of refractions within the prism. Alright? So, in order to calculate this R1 plus R2, we have taken a quadrilateral APNQ. Can you see in the figure? APNQ, this one, APNQ. Alright? So, APNQ, and we know that for the sum of the internal angles for a quadrilateral, it equals to 360 degrees. And since it is 360 degrees with all the sum, so we are taking first the angle of prism, that is A, then plus angle APN. You see the APN, which is where the PN is the normal, so this is 90 degrees. Then we have AQN, which is again QN is the normal, so this is again 90 degrees. And obviously the P and Q, this one. Now, the interesting part is this, P and Q. Now, what is P and Q? You can see in this first bracket, in the next step, we are writing that P and Q is equal to 180 degree minus R1 minus R2. Now, why I am writing this? This we have to understand. You see, we can have a triangle. We can see a triangle P and Q. Can you see the triangle there? And in that triangle, the sum of the three angles of a triangle is 180 degrees. So, I am calculating P and Q. And in order to do that, I am just subtracting two angles R1 and R2 from 180 degrees. So, this is equal to P and Q. And the rest, this is 90, which is 180 degrees. Angle A remains the same. So, if you calculate everything, finally everything will get cancelled. This 180, 180, 360 and everything. And R1, R2, I will take that side. So, finally we are having this expression. R1 plus R2 equals to angle A, which is the angle of the prism. Okay? So, this expression, this one, whatever we have got, will substitute here. And finally, we can see the final expression to be this one. Delta equals to I plus E minus A. So, from this thing, angle of deviation is equal to angle of incidence, angle of emergence minus angle of prism. So this states us that what are the factors that will actually affect the angle of deviation. And what are these?
First one, angle of incidence. Second, angle of emergence, which is again dependent on angle of incidence as well as the refractive index of the prism, because there are, you know, refractions occurring. And the last one, which is obviously the very intrinsic property of a particular prism we have taken for this experiment, and that is the angle of prism, which is A. So, in a nutshell, we can actually summarize this whole thing. We have to remember this formula, because, you know, this will actually tell us how to deal with the small problems. Basically comes for 2 marks, where we have to calculate the angle of deviation or maybe angle of prism. The rest of the values will be given. So this formula is very important. Delta equals to I plus E minus A. Please remember this, all of you. And the next thing is, from this expression, from this derivation, what we have understood is very simple. What are the factors that actually affects the angle of deviation through a prism? The first thing, it is given in your book, you can go through it. There are boldly written in your book. Since I am using a particular version or particular edition, which is may not be your edition that you are using right now for 2021 batch. The factors which are, I repeat, the angle of incidence, obviously, the refractive index of the prism, and obviously the angle of prism. These are the factors that affects the angle of deviation. Alright? Okay, so as of now, we have got this expression. That is, angle of deviation for prism is equal to I plus E minus A. Alright? Great. Now, we have to think, you know, in physics, we always try to know that what will be the minimum value of something and what will be the maximum value of something, and that is called the range of values. Like, this is angle of deviation, that is, this is the angle by which the light is actually deviating from its actual path. Now, we want to know the range. That means that how much deviation can occur, what is the maximum deviation, what can be the minimum deviation. Now, the maximum deviation is not included right now in past 10 syllabus. We are going for the minimum deviation. Okay? So, what is minimum deviation? Now, we say that minimum deviation can occur only when the condition, I repeat, the condition for minimum deviation, please understand this. Now, what is the condition? Condition is angle of incidence should be equal to angle of emergence. That means I should be equal to E. Alright, so that way I can write the delta minimum is equal to 2I minus E. So, this is what we can say. The expression for the minimum angle of deviation that can occur through this prism, and this can occur only when the angle of incidence is equal to angle of emergence. This is the condition, I repeat, this is the condition for minimum angle of deviation. Alright, and now we have a graph showing this. And that graph is also given in your book. I would like you, the picture will come up right now.
Now you can see the picture which is popping up here. Okay, so look at this diagram carefully. The graph I was drawing on the board is that only, is actually showing you how the angle of deviation, it varies with respect to angle of incidence. And as you know, I have already discussed with you that angle of incidence, when it is equal to angle of emergence, then what happens? The minimum deviation occurs. Okay, that you can see in the graph, the dotted line is projected on y-axis, and you can see there it is written is delta M. M means minimum. Okay, so this is the graph you have to practice. This is very, very important for your ICSC 2021. Okay, so be careful, draw this graph again and again so that it is accurate And don't forget the nature of the graph. It is very essential. All right. Now comes another picture. You can see there are three scenarios here on three equilateral prism. That means the angle of prism is 60 degree. Okay, when we say equilateral prism, the angle of prism is 60 degree. We can also say right angle isosceles prism, then the angle of prism will be 90 degree. This way we work. Okay. Anyways, so we can see three diagrams. It is an equilateral prism, so angle of prism is 60 degree, and usually for a glass prism we take the refractive index to be 1.5. usually it is average for a glass prism. All right. Now you see in the first diagram the angle of incidence is 70 degree and angle of emergence is 33 degree and angle of deviation is 43 degree. These three angles are very important and they can actually ask you to draw this diagram with this accurate angles. It is very difficult. Okay, so we have to practice this particular diagram a lot and lot of times actually, otherwise you won't be able to complete the ray diagram. In ICC they will just give you the equilateral triangle and the single ray, that is OP, marked 70 degree with the normal. The rest, whatever you can see in the diagram, you have to draw, and you have to draw with proper accuracy. Okay. And in the second diagram you can see the angle of incidence, it is 48 degree, and interestingly angle of emergence is 48 degree. So we can see here it is the case when angle of incidence is equal to angle of emergence. That means this is the case for minimum deviation. And you can see what is the minimum deviation. You can see here it is 36 degree. All right. And again in the third diagram the angle of incidence it is 30 degree, which is almost parallel to the base. And we can also see the angle of emergence, it is 77 degree, which means the angle of deviation is around 47. So it is again increased. So you can see from these three diagrams we have understood the angle of incidence and angle of emergence, when they are equal, then only the minimum deviation occurs through a glass prism. All right. So these three diagrams, please practice these three diagrams. All right. And these are very important, I'm telling you. Don't ignore this. Okay, let us do one problem. You can see it on the board. 60 degree glass prism has a refractive index 1.5. We have to find the angle of incidence due to minimum deviation. All right, so we have I have drawn the diagram. Please do copy this diagram in your classwork. And we know the minimum deviation occurs when angle of incidence is equal to angle of emergence. Okay, so we have the formula del m equals to 2i minus a. Now the interesting fact is that when angle of incidence is equal to angle of emergence, then the internal refraction angle of refractions are also equal. So we are assuming that to be r. As you can see, r1 equals to r2 equals to r. And from here we can derive an interesting fact that r is equal to a by 2. Okay, because 2r equals to a now. So r equals to a by 2, which is equal to 30 degree. Okay, so this conclusion we have drawn from this infos that they have given. So now there is a time for solving the problem. So we have calculated that angle of refraction is 30 degree using the general formula. Now we are using Snell's law, sin I by sin r equals to 1 mu 2. The refractive index of glass with respect to air is 1.5, we can see. And angle of refraction is 30 degree, we have put that. Now sin 30 is half. So sin I equals to 1.5 into half, that is 0.75. All right. Now sin I is equal to 0.75. Now this value you don't know, it doesn't come along in the standard table, but we know the value, we can fetch the value, and if this kind of problem comes, they will provide you the value. So if sine I equals to 0.75, then angle I is equal to 48.6 degree. Okay, so this is the value, that is the angle of incidence that they wanted to find out, and we have solved this problem. Okay, so just follow the steps. It's very simple, it's not complicated. Okay, these examples you can find it in your textbook, that is Concise Physics. I'm just sending this picture, as you can see here, as a reference. Please practice both the examples. These are very, very, very important for ICC, and it is not difficult to understand also. In the first example, they have given you a prism, an object, and an observer, and then we have to just follow the basic rule of refraction of light through prism, that is, it will deviate the ray of light towards its base, and so finally when it light is reaching the observer, he is actually can see the image at I, not at O, that is being explained here in the first example. And the second one is pretty easy. It is just showing the emergent ray, and we have to just draw the incident ray and the normals and the path of the refracted ray through the prism, which is very simple, as we have already covered this. Okay, so please practice these examples. All right, so this was it, refraction through prism. I have explained the whole thing to you. Now there will be queries, which is the very, very usual thing. And before you have queries, you should go through the textbook, Concise Physics. This section you should complete. You should also do the question answers, and there will be 3-4 numericals after the question answer sessions. So please complete all this. And after that, we'll go online, or we'll come across to one-to-one doubts in our WhatsApp group. So keep studying, keep watching, and do subscribe and like these videos if it is working fine with you. Okay, bye-bye.